To everybody overseas now, American military members are missing after a bizarre and still mysterious incident at sea. This is the USS Fitzgerald, heavily damaged, her hull ripped open and flooded inside. Japan-based destroyer somehow collided with a massive cargo ship in waters off the coast of Japan. The ship's captain and several other sailors were hurt, but here's the real emergency. Seven crew members of this crew are still unaccounted for, as rescue crews are desperately searching right now. CNN international correspondent Alexandra Field is at the Navy's 7th Fleet headquarters in Japan and is joining us now. Alexandra, what are you hearing from Navy officials there about any progress they may have made in these efforts to find these seven American sailors?
Anna, it just can't hit any closer to home for them because they are out there right now searching for their own, those seven missing sailors. The last update coming within just about the last hour with the 7th Fleet saying that, yes, they are still searching. They have daylight on their side now. They were searching through the night, and they've got two areas to search. One, of course, would be the spot where the collision happened between these two hulking large boats, one that destroyer, the other that container ship. You had U.S. military vessels as well as aircraft, and also Japanese Coast Guard and defense vessels and aircraft out there in the search area where the collision happened, looking for those seven missing sailors. But the ship itself, the destroyer that was so heavily damaged in that collision, has made it back here to its base, and we understand that divers have in fact reached the destroyer. They are beginning their search, and that is operating under the possibility, Anna, that some of those seven sailors could actually be trapped inside the vessel, inside one of its compartments. We know this is a ship that took on a lot of water. The crew had to work furiously to pump that water out to stabilize the ship and to get it safely back here. This morning, though, they're still looking for all seven of those missing sailors, Anna.
And everyone's holding out hope for a miracle. Now, this area where these two ships collided, known to be a busy shipping zone, but what are you hearing about how it might have happened? I mean, all major ships, military and civilian, they have equipment on board that lets them see everything around them for miles. So any idea of how they collided?
Yeah, this is incredibly difficult to fathom. How does a 10,000-ton ship collide with a 30,000-ton ship? One is some 500 feet long, another some 700 feet long. Again, as you point out, this is a heavily trafficked area. It is just southwest of Yokosuka, where we are. We understand some 400 or 500 ships pass through there every day. So this is also highly regulated, heavily regulated water that is traversed by international ships carrying out international routes. That said, we've had some analysts proffer that because this is an area that's so heavily trafficked that if you are on a collision course, it could be difficult to maneuver out of that. But simply, it is too early, too soon to try and understand what could have caused this collision. That will be the work of the Japanese Coast Guard. They are in charge of this investigation, but all resources for now are really being most heavily deployed in terms of the search for these missing sailors, Anna.
Alexandra Field, thank you.